One of the most exciting boats in the Antigua Classic Regatta 2023 is New Moon. Carriacou Sloop, it's actually a modern version of 2010, but it's built in the tradition. And it's run by the Wish Foundation, the West Indies Sail Heritage. And it's all about teaching young Antiguans to sail. So I was very fortunate. I caught up with the crew at the end of day two to see how they've got. And I have with me Nevin, Jemiah, Rihanna and Preston.
Well, today it was more keeping the sails full because of the point of sail. Considering that we would have to ensure the point of sail is a bit more onto our course, it was hard for us to really stay on course and keep the spinning her up while trying to, you know, make it up to the top with all the rest. The most practice I've gotten with a third sail would have been when we did the tall ships in Europe. We tried our third sail on the yacht we were using, but otherwise, we've never tried it on New Moon. I preferred New Moon, partially because it's just smaller. And the taller ships, there's a lot of work to do. You have to consider each roll compared to our few ropes and lines and deck. They have so many more, so it's a bit funner as well to have a bit more fast pace, because on a taller ship everything is a bit slower. It's more team oriented though, so definitely a best of both worlds experience. Nevin and I have been sailing since 2019, when we first started with New Moon, but we have two new additions to the team as well, hoping to see these more people as well coming forward. So this is slow progress, more pushing into the foundation and seeing who's all interested. Looking forward to coming back with a bigger team next year though.
Started when I was 6, so that's about 12 years. And with the little boats that I just sail at my academy, this actually is a little bit harder because I've tried using the tiller and it was kind of harder to pull and push than normal sailboats that I've sailed.
I've always loved boats at a very young age. I started at age 8, but I stopped to do other sports.
Yeah.
And I just got back into sailing just over a year now, but I've been using the wheel, which is totally different from a tiller. And it's a bit challenging because I've never actually, I skipped all the process that I came back on. So it was a bit challenging.
Right, now, you all clearly love sailing. You've all been doing it one way or another for quite a while. Why do you think young people in Antigua think sailing's not for them?
Honestly, they don't like deep water and a lot of them don't like to swim. And it's just not a thing because most of their like grandparents never actually sail.
Yeah.
So they do like the traditional office type work. So you find a few that is actually interested in sailing, which is extremely rare. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Definitely actually want to become a captain, so that's what I'm working towards. I just finished my day skipper, so
Well done.
Going on to my coastal next.
Well, I do have interest in continuing sailing further on. What has really piqued my interest is more maintenance and IT. So setting up equipment, programming equipment, factors like that. So I'm hoping to keep with the bonds and ties I've made throughout the experience I had last year, and hopefully get a bit more into the blue economy itself.
I would like to be an engineer and a captain.
So I do, like everyone almost said, captain is what I'm trying to become.
Well, I mean, the fun of it is nice, and you could get a full-time job out of it. So that's my...
My advice to them would be to give it a try. A lot of us kind of second guess ourselves and doubt that it may be for us without even trying to put ourselves in the position. You can never hate something until you try it. You don't know what it is until you actually put your hands onto it. And
I would say that you live in an island, okay, might as well enjoy the water while you have it. And it was quite different for me because nobody in my family actually sailed. So I'm the only one in my family that actually took that route. And it's encouraging to others because they want to do more in water sports and all that. So I'm glad I could make a change. And being a female, you don't find much female in the industry. So I'm getting young females that actually want to do it. I'm like trying to inspire them. So that's one of my main goals.
Thanks so much. And good luck tomorrow. Last day tomorrow. All to play for.
Yes.
Well done. Thank you very much, guys.
Thank you so much.
Charlotte, new on New Moon, the end of day two. How's it been going?
Yeah, it's going really, really well. We have a team of students. Some of them are already in the team since 2019, but we have a couple of new students. And because we were in the yard till a week before class six, we didn't have a lot of time to do the sail training. But they are brilliant. So they just blend in the team and sail the race, and we're doing good. Yeah, thank you so much. That was a big feather on our head.
Yeah, that was well
after deserved. All the work, well deserved. And we are proud that we can keep the boat so beautiful. And it's a piece of tradition. And of course, you have to spend energy and time and a little bit of money to keep her the way as she looks today. And we do that with love because it's a beautiful, beautiful piece of tradition. Oh, we had a little bit of a challenging day. We never had a spinnaker, and we didn't have the time to train with a spinnaker. So we thought, let's just do it. So that's a little bit of a challenge. So after, I say, half an hour, we said, no, it's maybe something we shouldn't try in a race. So we took it down. And when we took the spinnaker down, the wind sort of died, and it was difficult. Then you're bobbing around, and it was a relief when the race committee said that they would shorten the course for our group of boats. And then we all cheered up and say, oh, just let's go to the finish. So the boat is moored outside the National Sailing Academy.
Yeah.
In a way, we work together because dinghy students, 12 year and older, they can join our program. So they get the experience to go out on the ocean, keelboat sailing, and of course, training for classic regatta, but other things like how do you anchor a boat? How does winches work? That's all what dinghy sailors don't know. Of course, they're familiar with the helm, what we have. And every Saturday we go out sailing. And then we have another program with the sailboat that's called Ocean Love Sailing Days. There we take out youngsters who not particularly able to sail, but are interested in that and can swim. And we go out on a more leisurely sail, and it's connected to our environmental program, where we do some seawater research, and then we sail to galleon, drop the hook, and they can swim and snorkel. And that's another program that we do. And sometimes from that program, youngsters get really interested in sailing, and then we send them to the National Sailing Academy to do dinghy sailing first and then come back to us.